Hello everyone, and welcome back to Remembering Game of Sarah Ten. Anyway, I just made a second set here and made a combat set with a few combinations. Mercury Master and Lamulanatu reduces damage from lava, laser beams, and similar things. I'm not sure if that will count, but anyway. Rose and Camille plus Lonely House Moving gives me an... Like, when I hit 0 HP, it revives me at 32 HP. Rose and Camille and Mercury Master boost damage of Knife, Axe, Rapier, and Katana, so Axe. La Mulana and Lonely House Moving boost damage of all of the whips. And having... La Mulana 2 makes enemies drop more souls, coins, and ammo, but that doesn't matter. La Mulana 2, and Rose and Camellia makes damage. Nearby enemies take damage whenever you get hit. So, you know, it's a combat set. With that said, let's get this done. Still trying to remember where that last tank jewel is.
Terrifying knowing that as difficult as this fight is shaping up to be, this is not her hardest state.
Right. Admittedly, I'm not being exactly, you know.
Careful.
Yeah, and there's technically more preparations I could do if I wanted to.
Yeah, maybe, you know, dump about 15 more hours into the game of preparation and get the final form. Fun fact about Echidna that we discovered, she gets older and stronger the longer in the game you go. Oh shit, you actually can see her fucking chest got bigger.
Wait, did they?
Yeah, you didn't notice that?
No.
The fucking red of her hair shifted, I was like, huh?
Yeah, that was... Yeah, she just got an extra minor details. Oh, you mean...
Yeah, she gets... Well, everything shifted on her body, so I was like, hmm. But yeah, not only does she age up during the fight, she ages up depending on how long it takes to get around to her.
Well...
Okay then. The fact that she's got those turrets attacking from multiple directions is not helping.
Nope. Oh no.
Yep.
Well,
she keeps knocking you back.
Yeah. I mean, at least it doesn't do like 200 damage like Tiamat did.
Fucking bitch.
Not like it helps since I couldn't really get away from it, but you know.
There's like a starter fight. She looked vaguely appealing. End of the fight. Oh god, no. Yeah, just look at her facial structure between first and second shift.
Oh yeah.
And you're the one who's played this game already. You know, I was like, this looks interesting. Opens TV tropes.
Look, the reason for that is that I'm playing it and you're watching it.
I was gonna take in details and question them.
Well.
I mean, not everyone can afford to go off topic in the middle of gameplay, like manners and just sword canes. I think you're getting your ass kicked.
Yeah, I'm trying my best not to get my ass handed to me right now.
You know, play Tohu, but it's easy to dodge.
Alright.
66%. Oh, so that fucking white health bar is like the hottest in the game, apparently.
Mm-hmm.
The white health bar she starts with is like supposed to be like the highest in the game.
Yes. Okay, progress.
And it makes it all the more, makes it all the more painful to fight.
Yep. Okay, I do have that selected. Yeah. I just make sure I have that ready ahead of time. I mean, I guess I could probably just go refill the Lamp of Time. I just had kind of assumed that it wouldn't work on her. For understandable reasons, I think.
I think people can get to her within like 3 hours of carry.
Yeah. Speedrunner side, I think, after all.
Imagine being just bad at the game and say you take the 35 plus hours to get to her, and she's just in her fucking final form from the get go and she's like, well, shit. How do you lose half your health before even getting to the first stage? It's not helping.
Yeah. Only half my health. Yeah, I'm just being reckless now. That was not a good move. This entire episode's gonna be a kid night, isn't it?
Probably. Tiamat was.
Should I just go refill my lamp and see if that works? And again, I still need to go via ammo, probably. I mean, it will still be a few free hits, but still.
Hey, here's an idea. Why don't you go get the weapon fairy and bring her?
You know, that's not a horrible idea. Oh, of course.
Hey, remember in the previous game when the weapon fairy was kind of useless?
Yeah, I mean, there were some uses for her.
Until you forgot to forget to unequip bombs and she starts chucking grenades everywhere.
Yeah, basically.
It'll hurt you like bullet hell. after to the golden woman. Let me go.
Alright, that's progress.
Now she is playing. That's gonna be just like TMS, where you gotta run like half the room to just survive it.
Yep. Stupid arm blocking everything and that.
Is it the Don Matthew?
Yes.
Jumped right into that one.
Yup.
Thank you.
Well, oh. So close.
The fact that her beam comes from four separate spots is kind of bullshit.
Do you mean four?
That's why I said four. I said three, then corrected to four.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I'm getting close.
Well, you don't jump into attacks.
Me like that. I think I'm doing slightly better. This is not a good time for that. Come on, again?
Holy shit!
I can't believe that worked.
Desperation attack, much?
That's a word for it? Yeah, imagine if I didn't have the apps to increase all the damage I do and then giving me that extra hit and everything.
The journey is nearing its end.
That's a word for it. There is one guardian left. I do not remember where the Ankh is. Giant's Flute. The last usable item. An artifact that allows you to hear the tongue of giants. Press the item button to focus on giants' voices. Also, alright. We can switch back to that now. I kinda forgot about this thing we found.
A child born to Orthrus and Echidna, the Giga. Wait, is that giant slime thing? Ugh. Cerberus is a chimera of a dog conjoined with a human. And what guarded former ruler of the underworld, Hades. After Hades' reign ended, Cerberus became Echidna's guard.
Which one was Orthrus? Oh, right.
The giant slime thing?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Anyway, Let's get out of the Hall of Malice, never to return, hopefully. Not like I'm looking forward to that last part. Whatever. Don't care. I'm off. Well, I think I remember where the last Angjul is. I'm not looking forward to it. Let's first save. Let's actually go and, you know, replenish the Lamp of Time. Might be useful.
Yeah.
Wonder if the Lamp of Time is useful against a certain squirrel monster.
Hmm.
Oh well, I guess we're gonna find out. But first, where was it? We did get a bit of a hint here. Typhoon. Gidna system log. The system has crashed due to the destruction of the energy source, Echidna's throne. Subsequently, Project Typhoon cannot be executed. The Olympian seizure of Eglana has been rendered impossible. When's the last time we saw one of those? Actually, that wasn't that long ago, but you know.
Yeah, it wasn't that long ago.
We got about a few of those now. And speaking of which, hey, I killed the demon when I hit now. But yeah, I think it's about to try something out. So,
yeah, doesn't seem to work on him.
Ow. I wonder.
And he's just telling you no.
That's over for it.
Red Husker's a little shit.
That's over for it. And there's a reason I did not want to get here. It's like, yeah, now I remember where the last Angjul was. He stole it way back in the Icefire treetop.
Hmm.
Oh yeah, that would probably be a good thing to do. You know what? Yeah, healing is fine for this one. Thank you. Finally. And you're acquired. That was the last of Raltatoskor for now. So we need to grab the Moon Mantra. And you stand on everywhere we have fought or found Raltatoskor. In order to unlock Restful Girl, I think it was his name.
Yeah, Graceful Gar. Okay, what was the point of just getting hit? You just jump up and then get whacked.
The point of that was it not being on purpose. Alright, so I'm just gonna wait for that guy to walk away. Or that happens. There is one more thing to do up there. To be precise, over here. A while ago, we did speak with... Alright, we can't actually enter here yet until we kill fucking Resvar Gear, so never mind. Yeah, I guess we might as well go on a ceiling spree. We have the last of the angels. In a while since we've been here, huh?
You could say.
Still takes more than one hit. Let's see, where else have we seen that guy? Well, Immortal Battlefield, of course. Fire up. I think it was here. Yeah. Let's see. Ice Fire Tree Top. If I remember correctly, there was one way up there. This one was actually in Ice Fire Treetop. Yes, yes, I know it's frigid. Enough. And there's the last spot. Alright. Now all we have to do is go back to the entrance of hell and we'll be able to... Not what I meant to do, but okay. And we'll be able to fight Resvalgir, the last sub-boss, I think? Oh well. I guess the easiest way would be to just go right through Valhalla. I'm not sure I'm actually prepared to fight him, mind you.
Doesn't look right.
I probably should have waited before going to Nibiru and taking the thing up there. Yeah, that thing's definitely not done yet, so... Well, I guess we're going the other way around. Elsewhere entirely. So I guess just use it when it's red, right?
He seemed a bit easier to deal with when he was a squirrel. Damn.
That's a word for it. Remember how to fight this guy in the least.
Well, clearly, however you're doing it right now is not the way.
Clearly. Especially since I can't even seem to get a hit in. Yeah, I'm gonna save that one for next time. So, yeah. Hope you all have fun. And we'll see you next time. Buh-bye!